right, now we'll go to setup. Setup's looking for some information, so we'll double click there. All right, this is getting ready for the fluid launcher, and we're just gonna go with the default settings there. Click OK. All right, so we'll go ahead with what we have here for the default settings here. Obviously, you can see how you can change things, different types of solvers. Instead of pressure-based, you go to density. You can go to a transient solver versus steady. Again, there's gonna be a lot more control you have here in Fluent than you would in SOLIDWORKS simulation. We're gonna go down here to models, and we're gonna be looking at the viscous laminar model. We're not really concerned about these other things, but again, you can see all the different things you have, lathe, there's acoustics, but we're gonna have it turned off. All right, so if you go here to viscous laminar and click on edit, again, see all the different models that you could possibly have. So there's an viscid model, right? You guys should know about that. Laminar model. I'm not actually familiar with Spalart Amaris. K epsilon and K omega, those are two different types of models that involve turbulence. K epsilon is probably the most popular one, and that's the one we're going to use. But then you can see all the other different models that are available here. All right. So just click on K epsilon, again, leave all the default values as they are, and click OK. Won't have to worry about materials here, because I think it obviously starts out with air, and that's fine. I'll go to boundary conditions, all right? So you can see all the different zones. These are the stuff we labeled, right? We labeled the velocity inlet, we had the pressure outlet, we had the far field. We didn't actually apply any boundary conditions to them. But check out the velocity inlet. If we look at what kind of type of inlet it is, it's a, oh my goodness, it's a velocity inlet. So because the name is so similar to what the different types that Fluent has, it kind of assumed, oh, it's called velocity inlet. I'm guessing you would like a velocity inlet there. And guess what? I do. All right, so that worked out really well. If you look at pressure outlet, hey, look, it's a pressure outlet. All right, again, there's other options here. You could have an exhaust fan, inlet vent, intake fan, et cetera, et cetera. All right, but it picked up that we wanted a pressure outlet. All right, so let's change some of those values. So we'll go back to velocity inlet, click on edit, and velocity magnitude we're gonna put in there is 30 meters per second. And again, so since we're dealing with turbulence, we have to specify some additional information. So we'll go to intensity and length scale, and keep it at 5%, and the length is 0.01 meters. All right. Basically, what that's doing is looking at, because the turbulence is going to create, what is turbulence? Big thing in turbulence that we're interested in? Eddies, right? So this length scale is looking at, you know, how finely should we look at those eddies and consider them as they're flowing around doing stuff. All right, so that's 0.01 there. Click OK. I'll go to pressure outlet and edit. All right, so this is gauge pressure. So gauge pressure means zero is atmospheric. All right, so I have to worry about that. Again, we'll change this to be the same as we had for velocity. So go to intensity and length scale, and we'll go with 5 and 0.01. And click on OK. All right, so let's just double check here. Check our symmetry out. So symmetry shows up as symmetry. That's always a good thing. And then, oh, I also want to show you the wall. So if you look at the far field, so notice that the far field, I called it a wall. Let's look under edit on that one. Notice the shear condition for that case. All right, no slip. So that's what we want there. Don't want to worry about slipping along the wall there. All right, so that's all good there. We're all set up with that. So let's come down here to solution initialization. And we're gonna change it to, instead of hybrid, do a standard initialization and do it based on the velocity inlet. All right, so what this whole initialization thing is it's gonna use an iterative solver. What does an iterative solver need to then solve? What's that? It needs a starting point, it needs a guess throughout the domain. So that's what this is gonna do. All right, it's gonna set things up with a guess about all the different things that it needs to know. And so if we go ahead and click on initialize, it's gonna do that. And that's all the excitement you get from that. Go ahead and click on run. We're gonna go to do 100 iterations. And then go to calculate. And you can watch it bring up a plot that shows the iterations. And this is showing convergence, right? Again, the iteration is showing how much change do we have between the value we calculated the first step to the next step. And we want to minimize that change. We want to see it to continue to decrease. And so that's when we watch this plot here. It's showing us that we're getting a certain type of convergence on each of the different residuals, right, or error that we have on these things, as it's highlighting in the upper left here, continuity, velocity in the X, Y, and Z, and K epsilon value. All right, but again, it gets to 100 iterations, it calls it quits because that's what we told it to stop at, and we click OK. All right, everybody's worked out there okay? All right, again, it saves it automatically. We don't have to do anything else here, so go ahead and close. All right, and so we're all greened up, green checked up, till we get to results. And so we can double click on results. All right, and I got this error yesterday and I kept running into it and was just trying to figure out what's going on. You may get this depending on where you saved your file at, and we can fix it really easy. But notice what happened here. If you ever looked in at your map drive, this should be, I think it's student files. Then there's a dollar sign and then there's a slash. Notice how the dollar sign, the slash is gone. Somehow it gets goofed up. I don't know how. In other places in ANSYS it shows it fine, but it's not liking this. So you need to save this on your on a local drive. So go ahead and close it. It should have everything saved at this point, so you should be all right. I got to close out of this here. All right, so I'll go ahead and close this guy. All right, so go find your folder. And for mine, I did mine in my downloads folder, which is linked to my network drive. So I need to go find my files here. So I saved it as basic probe fluent. And then I also need the folder, because the folder is where it saved all this, the fluent information from. So the folder is going to be the same name as my project file. So I'll come up here and select that as well. And I'm just going to copy and bring it over to the desktop. Actually, the desktop might even be mapped to your drive. So maybe the best thing is to do, if you go into the C drive and under users, and just paste it in there somewhere. So I did it here under probe. All right, so C drive users, find your username, and that'll be saved in the local drive. Obviously, if it's local, it's not going to go with you to the next place, so you just have to copy it back when we're done.